one of the fundamental issues in brain biology is that human glia are very different from those of lower species, of the usual experimental animals that we use in laboratory work, mice, rats. Well, these animals are more primitive in terms of their supporting cell populations of the brain, the glia. We realized that if we could take human glia and put them into mouse brains and do so in large enough numbers that we could start to study these, the human glia, in a live brain, but in this case within the mouse brain. One of the opportunities that this general type of approach gave us was to look at very uniquely human-specific infectious diseases. There are a wide variety of viruses in particular that only infect humans, and in some cases only infect very specific cell types. JCV is a virus. It's in a class that we call the polyomaviruses, but it's a virus that we all get early on when we're children. And normally it's harmless, but in patients who are immunosuppressed for some reason, we first started seeing this in the days of the initial chemotherapies for leukemia, lymphoma, later in the HIV epidemic, where patients, of course, have deficiencies in the immune systems, and much later in patients getting immunosuppressants for a variety of neurologic disorders. In all of these cases, we started to see this virus, JC virus, become infective and active. And these patients would then develop a terrible infection. It's called progressive multifocal leukoencephalopathy. And what it refers to is infection of the brain by the virus, where the virus normally spreads through the body. It normally doesn't get into brain tissue in particular. But in patients who are immunosuppressed or immune deficient, the brain's defenses are down, and the virus gets into the brain and causes infection very specifically of the glial cell types of the brain. What little was known about infection of the brain by JC virus, what was known about PML was that at the end of the day, you'd have an autopsied brain and you'd see that the white matter was destroyed. In more recent times, we can follow that process by MRI, but essentially we see the same thing. Once we'd established this model, the human glial chimeras, we asked the question, how does this virus infect the brain? We started by injecting baby mice with human glial progenitor cells. As these cells migrate throughout the brains of the animals, they become astrocytes and oligodendrocytes, and over time, those oligodendrocytes myelinate the brains. By the time they're 3 or 4 months old and fully myelinated, we then inject the human JC virus as a concentrate into the brains. The virus propagates throughout the brain to cause the complete infection of forebrain and brainstem both, ultimately causing the demyelination of the fully myelinated animal. At the cellular level, though, we found that it was actually the astrocytes that were the primary targets of infection. The virus replicated in the astrocytes, resulting in their lytic rupture. The virus then spread throughout the white matter of these animals and infected the oligodendrocytes, which then in turn underwent death in response to infection. That in turn resulted in demyelination and yielded the myelin loss that we observed in these animals. The result being that oligodendrocytes are being lost and myelin's being lost, but they're not the primary targets of the infection. Now that we have focused on the astrocyte as a target for therapeutic development, because we know that the astrocyte's the primary target for the virus itself, therefore we can go after preventing viral infection of the astrocyte, preventing viral replication in the astrocyte as our essentially treatment strategies. We now think that we have really a tremendous opportunity for going after the infection of the brain by JC virus very specifically in ways that we had not been able to do previously because we simply didn't have that degree of cellular understanding of the processes by which the virus is infecting the brain and essentially wreaking the havoc that it does within the adult human brain.